أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور ثم الذين كفروا بربهم يعدلون نحمده حمدا كثيرا يوافق نعمه ويتملق مزيده نحمده حمدا من أقر بعدم قدرته على وفائه بحق حمده سبحانه وتعالى ونستعينه استعانة من لا حول له ولا قوة إلا به ونستهديه بهداه الذي لا يضل من أنعم به عليه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله صلى الله عليه وسلم وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن خير الهدى حبيب الورى سيدنا محمد رسول الله يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. أما بعد, my dear brothers and sisters, in the hard and challenging times that we may live in, we may find ourselves exhausted, tired, in a life of chaos, of hecticness, trying to run in our busy days, day after day, running in a hamster wheel, getting after trying to solve one challenge to the other, from one aspiration, one need to the other. We might find ourselves in a state of spiritual tiredness. We're worn out. Our iman might start fading out, worn out as we're taking on too much. It is now more important than any other time to take few minutes, sometimes, to disconnect from all those hecticness of the horizons around us and take a deep look in the horizon within. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created a world, a deep well inside of any one of us. وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. And on your within, or your own selves, don't you see, don't you reflect, don't you ponder? When we take time and ponder within our own selves, ask the key questions of our core existence, why we are here on this life, what is our mission, where are we going, and why did we came? One would come to a conclusion. One of the key conclusions that a person would come to is that indeed to us belongs nothing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the sole owner of everything in this life. Our money, our wealth, our children, our families, our businesses, our aspirations, our situation, our challenges, all in the hands of the one sole creator, La ilaha illahu subhanahu. Even the things that is we consider closest to us, our bodies and flesh, belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And before I dwell a little bit deeper into this, I would like to narrate a related story just to get the context. The story of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. When he was on his journey from Palestine to Egypt, he was in the desert of Sinai, at nighttime, cold, he was looking for some guidance or some fire to warm up himself and his family. He saw a fire far away. فَقَالَ إِنِّيَ آنَ سُنَارَ. I indeed saw a fire far away. لَعَلِّيَ آتِيكُم مِّنْهَا بِقَبَسٍ أَوْ أَجِدُ عَلَى النَّارِ هُدَى. Maybe I should go and seek that fire. Maybe I could bring some torches of that fire to warm us up. Or maybe I can find some guidance to lead me to the way to Egypt. When he reached that fire, he indeed found guidance. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted for him a bigger guidance than simply leading him to Egypt. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided him the guidance that would lead him and the ummah, the nations of Banu Israel and the people, the generations after him, towards the creator of Egypt, towards the Lord of Egypt and the Lord of the whole universe. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started dialoguing with him, talking to him. He said, قَالَ إِنِّيَ أَنَا اللَّهُ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَاعْبُدْنِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him the essentials of the message, the summary of the message, the beautiful message of this faith. There is no God other than me, so worship me. وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي. And establish prayer to mention me. And then Allah azza wa jal wanted to make sure that he's ready for to be graduated, to bear that beautiful message and go all the way to the Pharaoh with that message. So Allah Azza wa Jalla started an interesting discussion with him. Allah Azza wa Jalla asked him about something that he was holding in his hand, a staff, a cane that he used to hold in his hand. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَمَا تِلْكَ بِيَمِينِكَ يَا مُوسَى. What is it in your hand, O Musa? And if you think about it, it is a strange way to ask the question. If you see someone with a cane in their hand, you will say, what is that cane in your hand? You won't say, what is that in your hand? Yet Allah Azza wa Jalla left it on the indefinite. What is it in your hand? In a way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to hear how Musa will express what that cane meant to him, and to express his relationship to him, to that cane, so that Allah Azza wa Jalla will seize it as a teaching opportunity to purify his soul and his heart, to be ready to bear the light of that message onward. So he said, قَالَ هِيَ عَصَايَ. He said, it is my staff. If you think about it, also the answer is kind of strange. If you're holding a phone in your hand, maybe it's a new phone, someone asks you, what is that phone? Or so what is that? You will say, it's a phone. It's a phone. You don't say it's my phone. If you say it's my phone, you kind of imply, it's implicit, it was not said explicitly, that it's very private to me. Like I probably customize it in a way that is very special to me. In the case of Musa alayhi salam, he said, it's my stuff. It's like I've done it from the, I am the one who chose the tree where to cut it from. I cut it on my size so I can lean on it. It should be on the right size of mine. It should not be smaller or bigger. It should be customized to me. And it should be the right size that I can go and be the tree so they can bear down some leaves to my flock. So basically it's really, I have a very strong, I own it so dearly. It is my stuff. And then he went and explained how special is it to him and how he owns it so dearly. I lean on it and I beat on the trees to bring down the leaves to my flock, and they have so many other uses of it. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla wanted to teach him one thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Alqiha ya Musa. And it's amazing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, drop it. He didn't say put it down, drop it. Like disconnect from it. فَلَمَّا أَلْقَاهَا فَأَلْقَاهَا فَإِذَا هِيَ حَيَّةٌ تَسْعَى. Suddenly, that thing that he thought he knew every single thing of it, that he owned it big time, suddenly transformed to something he would never imagine. It's not his thing anymore. It's a serpent. Rolling away. So his reaction was running away from the thing that he was holding so dearly. He was running. فَأَدْبَرَ مُعَقِّبًا وَفَأَدْبَرَ وَلَمْ يُعَقِّبْ. He ran away, he didn't even look behind. Suddenly, totally disconnected. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, now, قَالَ خُذْهَا. If it is truly yours, now hold it. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla, خُذْهَا وَلَا تَخَفْ. Don't worry. سَنُعِيدُهَا. It is me, I will put it down and make it back to the way it was before. So who's the owner now? It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you should realize that whatever you think, how much investment you did in it, it's not really belongs to you. You're not the one who dictates its fate. It's the one Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. خُذْهَا وَلَا تَخَفْ سَنُعِيدُهَا. I will return it to سِيرَتَهَا الْأُولَى, to its original situation. So back to our initial point. Once we go and reflect about what who we are and what we truly own, it is really mesmerizing that we come to realization that we indeed, even the things that are so intimate to us, that we think we control so dearly, do not belong to us. The thing that we feel closest to us is our own body. And a simple example is the agent. There are endless manifestations of how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the owner, is the controller of everything. But a simple example is the body of that we carry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted us in this dunya. The simple fact of its aging, it's transforming day after day behind our own ability. And you can see that example for, you can you see people you see in the TV, probably public figures or like the celebrities or people you might, or you know, head of states or like CEOs, people you see on TV. There comes a time you don't see them on the TV for anymore, and then maybe after 5-10 years you somehow see them back. And you're shocked. They're transformed so bigly. These were people who were used to dictate the fate of nations. Those are people who used to transform technologies. These are people who used to change the world in a way. They could not stop their body from worn out. Until you see them becoming amazingly old, cannot carry themselves maybe on a wheelchair, until one day you hear that first person pass away. So that very essential, that very intimate, closest thing, this is our body, that we anchor anything that we hold as our in our possession to it. We say, that's my tablet, that's my thing, which means it belongs to me. Even myself, when I anchor other things to it, it belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تَبْصِرُونَ. So Allah Azza wa Jal has borrowed us, this body, that flesh, that we might occupy it for a set time. And then when the time is due, we'll give that gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala back to the originator. It will transform back into the earth from which it originated, and then we'll go continue our journey in the hereafter, inshallah ta'ala. Like a tree bearing fruits, You see the fruit blossoming, probably with bud, and then blossoming and becoming a fruit. And then as it stands on the fruit, the tree longer and longer, it starts ripening up, and then it becomes very rotten. And then it drops down. And this will dissolve into the earth another time, one more time. And then a new generation of fruits are bared again. And that's the cycle of life. Us, in a way, we are that those fruits, that buds, that blossoming from that tree. So whomever fruits grows old, it drops down on the ground and then back to the earth from where we originated. So it is very essential, my brothers, my sisters, my estimated elders and young friends, it is very essential to take time to reflect on ourselves, on our faith, to dignify and make a plan for this short time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted us. What is it that we're going to do with it? The time that we have given in this life, how long is it? How long is it? It's nothing. You ask anyone, we're here from different ages, you ask anyone and say, look back, did you live for long? You say, no, my life was very short. It's like yesterday, I remember when I was running around. Okay, even I don't even know how come I grew up, and if you have children, how can they have children? It's like, yes, like everything happened in a snip. Nobody will tell you, yeah, I have for so long, I'm tired of life. Don't want to live in that too long. It's very short. No matter what is it, 100, 200 times, no matter what is it, it is very short. So there is no sense of length in life, but there is sense of breath. Breath. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes Jannah. He says, عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ. Its breath is like heavens and earth. Not length. Because length, whatever it is, like anything that is counted, is going to end one day. It's gone. The day, like even if you have 200 years in your lifespan, the day you start counting counting down, year one, year two, year three, it's gone. But the breath can be endless. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's why Allah azza wa jalla, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make the message, the dua, Allahu barik illahumma fi a'marina. Wa Allah put barakah in our, not wa Allah make our lives longer, make us live longer, wa Allah make our lives have more blessing, more blessed. This means that the single minute, how can your life transform into being a blessed life? That the minute becomes 10 minutes. Because when you do a good deed in your minute, it's like 10 times. When you're given a charity, it's like 10 times. Suddenly you transform the 1 hour you spent in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doing good deeds or impacting people's life in a positive way, or doing whatever that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes and benefits yourself or the others. Now you're multifolding the breath of that minute. It's 1 minute still, but you made it eternal. When you take that $1 and give it to charity for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that minute or second or whatever you give that $1, you transform it into something eternal. Because you're going to find it in the hereafter, which is eternal. You take that moment you spent making dhikr of Allah, saying La ilaha illallah. It may take you a second. You take it and transform it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam helped many ahadith, was trying to help us do this connection. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he says, whomever says subhanallah wa bihamda, a tree is planted for him in the Jannah, that basically helps making that connection that I'm transforming this minute that is going to go and make it eternal, because now a tree is eternal in Jannah, and suddenly I make that transformation and live a breath that is endless. So, and we see this manifestation of how life, the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in life, that generation will come, small will be born, they will grow up old, and then will perish, get old, they will perish, new generation will come afterwards. And subhanallah, you see it even in people you might know, reading the news, or family, or acquaintances, or people you hear about. You start hearing that a person of a certain, from a certain generation passed away. Then, probably years or a couple of years ago, after someone else who is a comparable age, like probably within the 10 years age range, and then someone else, and maybe a cousin, and then maybe uncle, and maybe grandpa of a friend, and all within the same age range, until that generation perishes, and the new generation now holds up, and the death is start taking away from that generation. Of course, death does not select from small or young, but there is a general rule. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "A'maru ummati bayna 60 wa 70." The lifespan of my ummah is within the 60s or 70s. So, in a way, that has a general rule that we grow up, we try hard to grow up our children, make our families, you know, successful, buy homes, whatever our aspirations is. But the reality is, we'll go and then we'll grow the next generation, we'll make sure they stand up, and then our leaf will weaken up and be ready to fall down into the earth again. Like a tree. The tree every year it will grow up new leaves, the leaves will grow up, new, and then will drop down, and then buds, new buds will come in, a generation after generation. So reflecting on these essential, basic things that are we see every day, but in the hecticness of life we tend to forget, is essential to make sure we recalibrate our compass. It's essential to make sure we understand our priorities. And also it's essential that we still, in the high headwinds that will come, challenging our faith, challenging our community, challenging ourselves, our tree is deep-rooted. Shajaratul Mubarakah asluha thabitun. Our trees are deep within rooted because our heart is deep-rooted. We took a moment to reflect and strengthen those roots, those essentials, that no matter how high the high winds that will come from above, will stay. Faruha thabitun wa asluha fi sama. The tree will, trunk will remain strong up high because it's well-rooted and will lean peacefully in full serenity in the face of any headwinds that will come up. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولجميع المسلمين فاستغفروا. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله. So my dear brothers and sisters, this time, small short time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted us, we know that we are being accountable for every single moment that went of it, that goes out of it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لَا تَزُولُ قَدَمَ ابْنِ آدَمَ حَتَّى يُسْأَلَ عَنْ أَرْبَعَ. And the feet of the son of Adam will not move in the day of judgment until he asks about four things. And the first of them, عَنْ عُمْرِهِ فِي مَا أَفْنَى. His life, his time that you're granted in this life, how did you spend it? How did you spend it? It is, our lifetime is a capital Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted us. And we either, everyone is going to be trading it. وَأَنَّ كُلَّكُمْ غَادٍ فَمُعْتِقُ نَفْسَهُ أَوْ مُرْمُوبِقَهَا. Everyone is trading in his own lifetime, in his capital Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave. So either you make it a profit or you bring it back to bankruptcy. And the profit is when, as we said, we transform that 1 minute and make it 10 times fold and 20 times fold and 70 times fold by spending it in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pleases. The journey that we are given here, brothers and sisters, that we're going to go over, that we're going to travel in, is to a single destiny. وَأَنَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ الْمُنْتَهَىٰ. And to your Lord is the end destination. يَا أَيُّهَا الْإِنسَانُ إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ كَدْحَىٰ. Oh, human being, you will go very busy in your life, but to you or to your Lord at the end. فَمُلَاقِي. At the end, you're going to meet your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we all got to be distant to the single destination, but the way we choose to our destination is in our hands. It's either the way of pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way that Allah azza wa jalla is content with, is pleased with, or the way of his wrath. But at the end, we'll find ourselves towards the same destination, facing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Either longing to see him subhanahu azza wa jalla because we develop so much love for him and he's looking, love and yearn to see him subhanahu wa ta'ala, or ma'adallah, trembling because we know that we haven't set forth what is that moment worth. I give a small example, my dear brothers and sisters. I'm basically reconnecting with those essentials. Those are very essential things that like everyone knows. There is no new information in what I have said. But it's simply a reminder to myself and to all my brothers and sisters, in the time where probably we may be hectic and think and forget, to hold on into the essentials. Hold on and take that moment to reflect within and connect and understand the value of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted us. When person engage in connecting with his Lord, when a person embarks in a journey, those moments will spark an urge in every human being, a sister and a brother, that they want to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Will spark a strong love in the heart of every human being that they want to go and see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Strong yearning to Jannah, to the paradise. Now they start working hard to transform any capital they get to that. And that will give a human in this life a transcendent and eternal pleasure. The sadaqah that you give, maybe the time of it goes away, but the joy, the sweetness, the serenity that you find in your heart and in your life is eternal. And that's why Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah used to talk about al-wujud al-thani, the second existence. He referred to it as when you actually embark in that strong urge and desire to love Allah Azza wa Jalla, to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Suddenly, all that you want is how you get more of it. Suddenly you have this uns, this serenity when you sit down and remember Allah Azza wa Jal. Suddenly you don't find yourself, you like to go to the bad places anymore. Yourself no longer want to do it. Because that spark has light up a light inside your heart. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, Allahu nuru samawati wal ard. Allah Ta'ala is the light of the heavens and the earth. Mathalu nurihi, the example of His light, kamishkatin, like a niche, fiha misbah. The niche is our chest. The misbah, the lamp, is our heart. The lamp by itself cannot light up. What does it need? It needs a source of energy. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes where that source of energy comes. It says, فِي أَزْمِصْبَاحُ فِي زُجَاجَةَ الزُّجَاجَةُ كَأَنَّهَا كَوْكَبٌ ذُرِّي. It's like a shining star. يُقَدُ, where does the source comes from? مِن شَجَرَةٍ زَيْتُونَةٍ مُبَارَكَةٍ زَيْتُونَةٍ لَا شَرْقِيَّةٍ وَلَا غَرْبِيَّةٍ. From a blessed oil, olive tree. That oil that lights up that lamp comes from a blessed tree. That blessed tree is the tree of revelation of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the spark, our connection with the book of Allah Azza wa Jalla, suddenly brings that light, that spark of light into our heart, and suddenly we start seeing things differently, even reading the book of Allah Azza wa Jalla differently. Zaytunati mubarakatin, yakadu zaytuha yudhi'u walau lam tasbihu nar. That revelation in and itself would shine without even touching the heart of everyone. So what of anyone? How about if it touches your heart? It sparks, the whole thing will shine before your eyes. Suddenly you see things differently. Suddenly issues and challenges are no longer trembling you. Suddenly you don't self yourself in anxiety and sorrow when you lose something. Suddenly the life means something different to you. And that's a call, inshallah, Azza wa Jalla, make us all taste from that moment and live that life, inshallah, Azza wa Jalla. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless all of you, our parents, our children, our community. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to grant us being close to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, to help, to remind us always, to make us always stand fast to the essentials of why He brought us here. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I haven't created man or jinn except to worship me. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ.